Not all Shockwave devices are created equal. Some only treat the surface. Others hit the root of pathology.
Radio Shockwave and a focused Shockwave. You want to pair those two together in order for the best outcomes. The one that has the most data is the one that you're going to have to spend a little bit more time with and use two different machines.
So which one delivers the best outcomes? Watch to find out.
What Shockwave device is the best? What is your Shockwave device of choice?
So I think that the one that is the best is the we don't know. There's kind of two major ones that are out there right now. One contains a radio Shockwave and a focused Shockwave. So radio, we like to think of as a wide paintbrush that covers a large area. And it's a really loud machine, and it's like a little mini jackhammer. Creates these ultrasonic waves that spread out in a very wide radial kind of manner.
Don't forget, if you want more about the business of Orthobiologics, I have a podcast, or you can go on my website, The Business of Orthobiologics, and tune in.
If you threw a pebble in a pond and those waves spread out and go out wide. Then to make that most effective, you need to pair that with focus shock waves. So focus is the opposite. So we're focusing into a discrete point. It's also what I call my truth finder, meaning if you put that focus shockwave over an area that doesn't have pathology, you usually don't feel anything. As soon as you get it over an area tendinopathy, over a partial tear, it lights that patient up. You're getting it directly on the spot that has pathology. So when we're using the one device, you want to pair those two together in order for the best outcomes. Then there's another device that's both focused and radio in one is the way I think of it. It has focused waves with an unfocused wave over top. So it allows you to both hit a wide area like a cone, but then also pinpoints different areas at that different depths. To my knowledge, I've seen no head-to-head study comparing the two. And from a time standpoint, the second one seems to be a little bit faster because, hey, you only have to use one machine rather than two. But from a research standpoint, the one that has both radio and focus has more data out there to support it. So I think that we don't know yet. I think that there's some pros and cons with both of them, but the one that has the most data is the one that you're gonna have to spend a little bit more time with and use two different machines.
Don't miss out. Please subscribe to our newsletter now to stay ahead of the world of Orthobiologics. You can find the link below.